This is an apple. It's looking real good. And then we got there's a cherry over here. It's getting hit hard by the leaf cutter bees, but it's all right. There were even some cherries on there last time I looked. Yeah, not ripe yet. Check it out. Cherries in Arizona.
No kidding.
That's a Morello cherry. I guess they have a relatively low need for chill hours.
The battery shack?
Yeah, we're gonna build some wind generating capacity right above it to keep the batteries charged.
Nice.
And this is an electric car project that is
a great workshop space, and of course the much needed shade in the desert.
This is a three-phase AC motor, kind of leftover industrial whatever. They're dime a dozen, that's an exaggeration, but there's a lot of them around, just off the shelf. And so we aim to mount that into the Mercedes, and then here's a little controller that drives it. Batteries feed in one side, and three-phase AC power comes out the other, 240 volts. And that's just a question of batteries. Right now we got the lead acid batteries, but the lithium ones will be out. They are out if you can afford them. Price will come down over time.
Over time, yeah.
Yeah, lithium is very abundant. Number three on the periodic table. Oh, hey, we filled up our rain barrel. Hey, Holmes. This was an addition, doubled that capacity. That's what we thought we were featuring on the Renovation Nation, but they didn't even show any of that part.
Nice.
Yeah, this is solar shower, and it comes out mighty hot. Scalding this time of year, yeah. Go ahead, I dare you.
Is it pretty hot?
Yeah, it's really hot.
Wow.
And of course, in summertime, nobody wants a hot shower anyway.
Not really.
Wintertime, don't have enough hot water.
Nice, though. I like the shower.
Yeah, it needs a little more work on the roof. Lots of grapes. How's this for shade?
Oh, it's beautiful. Heavenly canopy of grapes. The bees are loving it, huh?
Those are leafcutter bees. And the grapes seem to keep up with those bees all right, but yeah, they take big chunks of the leaves out and haul it back to make a nest. They're kind of a nuisance. And they hit some of the fruit trees pretty hard.
Little desert oasis.
Yeah, there's lots of lettuce going to seed, but these tomatoes are all volunteers. We did not plant them.
What is that purple plant there?
Hmm? Oh, this is an amaranth. And we'll want to get that seed head out before it lets loose, but it's pretty.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, if we let it spread its seed in here, it'll be everywhere. And that's what I've noticed about certain plants, like the parsley. Last year it was, still got these flowers here.
Mm-hmm.
These things were just so thick in here, they were spreading everywhere. It's pretty, but growing flowers is not my business. I'm going to growing food. Uh-oh.
Whoops.
Sorry. Let's put it over here in the brush.
So how's the water system work?
Hmm?
How does the water system work in here?
Oh, there's a well. And there's that well, we have another well, and then there's one over by the Moon's Goat.
And then some junk that he bought.
He uses a fan if there's no wind, whatever, and separates the seed from the part not seed. Sizes. The roofing is mostly recycled. We bought a little bit of lumber for the cross pieces.
What kind of wood is that?
Pine, ponderosa pine. Yeah, it was all dead stuff.
I like it.
We just kind of found a stand of good wood that had died in a fire. They got this on the Renovation Nation program. We filmed like 3 times. Steve and I were like walking through the door and we're talking and we're just like, okay, let's do it again. This time the camera's over here. We're like, oh man.
Nice.
Yeah, it's kind of a nice little space.
Can you briefly describe the process of building it?
Well, on this one we excavated down about 3 feet, started laying bags of earth and pack them, and then between each layers of bags, put in 2 strands of barbed wire, 4-point barbed wire, not 3-point. And with this building, we used something that we measured, a pole from the center that told us exactly where the bags were to be placed at any given elevation.
Mm-hmm.
And instead of closing the dome of earth, which was difficult to do without tubing material, we did a double dome of ferro cement. And the wood is just kind of decorative. It holds the ferro cement up while the ferro cement is being made, but it doesn't really end up doing anything structural at the end.
This looks nice.
Yeah, it does.
Nice window.